يا رسول الله السلام عليك حبيبي يا نبي الله السلام عليك يا رسول الله السلام عليك حبيبي يا نبي الله يا رسول الله صلى الله على
As Muslims all over the world face Qibla for prayers, so do all schools focus on Qibla schools to emulate beautiful innovations. Our nursery and primary schools enjoy good teaching aid facilities as our team of qualified and committed teachers. Leave no stone unturned, ranging from academics to moral and religious teachings. Qibla High School as well is a place to be with spacious playground, very conducive learning environment, library, ICT and indoor games rooms and not only well-stocked but also equipped with state-of-the-art facilities. Our students perform brilliantly well at all external examinations as well as various co- and extracurricular activities. Qibla Schools, comprising of preparatory and high schools, is at plot 225, Ibadan Southwest Multipurpose Scheme at Leshinloye, Ibadan. Telephone 0805-272-5253 or 0803-313-2027. Qibla Schools, we set the pace.
وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته We thank Allah سبحانه وتعالى the treasure of the womankind the sustainer of the whole universe We testify to His oneness that He has no associate as the partner We also testify to the messengership of Holy Prophet Muhammad May the peace and benediction of Allah be upon his noble soul, his household, his companions, and the entirety of Muslims till the day of resurrection. We want to discuss Ashura al-Awaqim in Ramadan, that is, the last 10 days of Ramadan. What are the beauties of these last 10 days, and what are those things expected of us as Muslims? Whom Allah has favored with life up to this moment. Because now we are about to graduate from the second phase of Ramadan to the last phase, which is the last 10 days of Ramadan. And before entering into the last 10 days of Ramadan, we should know those things expected of us so that we'll be able to maximize our reward. From Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the first thing that we need to know about the last 10 days of Ramadan is that the Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it a sunnah to go on i'tikaf in the last 10 days of Ramadan. And this i'tikaf simply means seclusion in the masjid, seclusion in the house of Allah. For someone to stick to the mosque of Allah without leaving the mosque except on necessities. For someone to stay in the mosque for the last 10 days of Ramadan. That was called al-i'tikaf. And whoever we go for i'tikaf, it is expected of him that he should have been in the masjid before the sun sets on the 28th of Ramadan. So the person will have been settled in the mosque before the sun set and he won't leave the mosque, he won't exit the mosque except when the moon of Shawwal, when the crescent of Shawwal is sighted or when they have made declaration for Eid al-Fitr and that is how it is in the Sunnah. And why is it that al-Luzum fil Masjid, seclusion in the mosque has been prescribed by the Prophet or has been made his tradition? It's because of the fact that these last 10 days happen to be the best days in the month of Ramadan, even the best days among the days of our life, particularly the night of those 10 days. Because the scholars, they have contended on the best days of our life. Some people, they say that the first 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah, and some said the last 10 days of Ramadan. But the popular opinion of the scholars is that the days of the first 10 days of Zulhijjah are the best days. And meanwhile, the best nights are found in the last 10 nights of Ramadan. So that is telling us that we still have avenue to exploit the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to exploit the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we are being careless on the way and manner we use our first 20 days in the month of Ramadan, then we still have avenue to gain the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This last 10 days is powerful to the extent that what someone might have missed in the first 20, one may still gain it in this last 10 days of Ramadan, if that person is ready to serve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the best form. And why is it that these 10 days of Ramadan are so magnificent to the extent that one can still accomplish the mercy of Allah therein? It's because of a night that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed within the last 10 days of Ramadan. And that night is known as Laylatul Qadr. And what is special about this night? There are so many things that are special about this life, simply because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us in Quran that it is the night of power. It is a night of majesty, a night of decree, wherein Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decrees every matter, everything that will come into being for the whole coming year. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed Quran on this night that is known as Laylatul Qadr. So if we want to look at it one after the other, let's first look at the essence of this night via the revelation of Quran as number one. Our Quran, the scholars of Islam, particularly Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, he said, أنزل الله القرآن جملة واحدة من لول محفوظ إلى بيت العزة من سماء الدنيا. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed Quran as a whole from lawl mahfuz to the Bayt al-Izzah, that is a house that is located in the closest heaven to the heart. So that house, the Prophet ﷺ told us that 70,000 angels, they circumambulate the house on a daily basis. And the 70,000 that circumambulated the house today will not come again to circumambulate the house till the day of judgment. From the hadith we know that the number or the population of angels is very much compared to the population of mankind. That is why the Quran has been understood to be revealed on the night of a majesty, based on this say of Abdullah ibn Abbas, that the whole Quran was revealed to Bayt al-Izzah in the closest heaven to the earth. And it is from that house, it is from that place, that the angel Jibril was bringing it bit by bit to the Prophet for good 23 years. And for this reason, that our guidance, our Musa, our book, was revealed on the night of power that is found within the last 10 days of Ramadan, that makes that day to be very magnificent. That makes that day to be a day that nobody can have a similitude in terms of good deeds in all other days aside the days within the last 10 days of Ramadan. And even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah Al-Baqarah, in Quran chapter 44, verse 3, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ
إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ فِي لَيْلَةٍ مُبَارَكَةٍ إِنَّا كُنَّا مُنذِرِينَ.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we revealed it in the night of power, in the night of blessing. That is, Allah is telling us that Quran was revealed by him in the last 10 days of Ramadan, particularly on a blessed night, which is the Laylatul Qadr. That is the night that Allah is referring to here as Laylatul Mubarakah, that is a blessed night. Inna kunna mudhirin. Allah says we are ever warning. So this verse of Quran means all other verses of Quran testifies to it that Quran was actually revealed on the night of majesty. Another thing that is special about this night is that every matter of ordinance is decreed therein. So everything that will happen for the whole coming year in terms of deaths, in terms of births, in terms of provisions, in terms of calamity that will befall the man, it is in this night that every matter is decreed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Dukhan that فِيهَا يُفْرَقُ كُلُّ عَمْرٍ حَكِيمٍ, that every matter of ordinance is decreed therein. So it is this night that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will decree everything that will come into existence for the whole coming year. So somebody that will become rich, somebody that will die, somebody that will be given birth to, somebody that calamity will befall him, and the kind of calamity that will befall him. Every matter of ordinance is decreed in this night of power. And that is why it is highly advisable that every faithful believer should be prayerful and should turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in repentance and by seeking his fortune and mercy in this night of Laylatul Qadr that falls within the last 10 days of Ramadan. Another thing about this night is that the act of ibadah carried out in this night supersedes the life of Eid carried out in 1,000 months. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Quran chapter 7 verse 3 that Laylatul Qadr khayrun min alf shahr, that the night is better than 1,000 months. What actually led to this night? Why is it that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed the Ummah of the Prophet with this night of majesty? Inshallah, tomorrow we shall dwell more on that. We pray that may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us better understanding of this message than the way it has been presented. The school for which the message is coming, Allah continue to elevate the school. And may the flag of the school remain higher and higher. Yaqila hawla wala quwwata إلا بالعلم العظيم. أقول ما تسمعون أستغفر الله لكم سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.
Talking of schools with clear vision and mission, Kibla schools maintain a comfortable lead.
With the variety stocked for all ages, children don't miss home. Our teachers are dedicated, caring, and hardworking, and that's why we stand out among our equals.
Kibla schools is situated in a serene environment with well-ventilated classrooms,
standard laboratory,
fully stocked library,
and ICT room.
School bus are praised to move students to and fro with parts
and other facilities at hand
to develop and all our students.
The fear of God is not left behind, as we are not only taught the word of God but also made to practice under the supervision of our well-informed malams.
Situated at plot 225 Ibadan Southwest Local Government Multipurpose Scheme, Alleged Lawyer Ibadan.
Telephone 0805 272 5253 0803 313 2027.
Learning with direction. Ya Rasulallah.